Good morning from Pitigliano. Today I'm going out of Tuscany to Umbria. Umbria is a piece of land very close to Tuscany, but as you know, Italy is divided into counties, and Umbria is the less famous county here in Italy. Should be just as beautiful as Tuscany, but less of a reputation. So let's find out what's there to see in Umbria. Okay, so I'm in Umbria now, and I reached my first destination. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's right there in the distance. Marmore Falls. The waterfall of Marmore. Which is the highest and the biggest non-natural waterfall in the world. 165 meters. So yeah, so the price is 10 euros a person. For one person like me, it's fine. But if you're a family, it can get a bit expensive. What they basically told me is that I have 1 hour to enjoy the beautiful waterfall, because in 1 p.m. they're shutting down the water. And what do I mean by that? I'll explain to you in a bit, but first let's go inside the park and see this wonder. We go inside and look, just, oh my god, this is incredible. I don't think I've ever seen something quite like it. It's, as I told you, it's the highest non-natural waterfall in the world. In the year 271 BC, more than 2,000 years ago, there was this count who ruled here in the name of the Roman Empire, of course. And the people who inhabited this place had a problem. And the problem was mosquitoes, right? Just like in the good old days, just like today, when you have water that stands still in a swamp, you get mosquitoes, and the mosquitoes give you malaria. But the Roman ingenuity came for the help of the locals. And this count said, basically, what's the problem? Let's divert the waters to this hilltop we have here next door, and this way you won't have a swamp problem anymore. Ingenious. They basically diverted the water and created this waterfall. Today it double operates as a power plant. So there's a dam upstairs, and in 1 o'clock they shut it down. So they basically control when the water comes in and out. The water drops are everywhere, keeping you cool and chill in this hot day here in Umbria. Wow. Just think about the Roman ingenuity over 2,000 years ago. Just think about it. They had a problem. Swamps, mosquitoes, death. And they solved it, thus creating this wonder that still withstands more than 2,000 years later. Words can't describe it. So I met this guy, Matteo, and he is actually coming here for 30... Ciao, Matteo. And he's coming for 30 years to do the kayak inside the cascade.
Sì.
Ma come si fa?
Si fa con anni di esperienza, non può farlo chiunque. Io sono quasi 40 anni che parlo in kayak.
Ma si può iniziare su e finire giù?
No.
Sì? Oddio.
Ma bisogna essere esperti, molto esperti.
In quale senso? Perché si può morire.
È impegnativo.
Wow. E la moglie ti lascia farlo? Non ha problemi. Ah, il figlio anche? È una cosa della famiglia, diciamo. Va bene, in bocca al lupo.
Ciao. Ciao, grazie.
Grazie. Ciao. So you see, guys, people come here to do the kayaks inside the waterfalls. That's just crazy. My mom would kill me. Now, there are three main ways to go up. I think I'm probably gonna go with the easiest one. Just joking, I'm gonna take the hardest one. So the thing is, guys, I'm afraid the camera will get wet, so you're inside my head right now as I'm trying to make my way across this bridge here. I don't know if you guys can see it. Oh god. Yeah, let's do it. Oh my god. Italy isn't the most famous for its infrastructure, right? So each time you cross a bridge, you do it at your own risk. Now, this is what I should have done. Get those water coats, like those smart, smart people. But dove si dice? Mi deve prendere uno di questi? Sì? Tu prendi
tutto acqua.
Vabbè, grazie mille.
50 non ce l'hai.
Non ce l'hai, vabbè. Ecco, grazie. Ok. Mission accomplished. Now, let's put this thing on. Let's hope the camera survives. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I made it. Oh my god, so much water. This is incredible, but oh my god, so much water. Okay, I'm gonna go down. Run away. Oh, I'm so wet. Okay, up we go. Now, I'm in a race against time because in 15 minutes they're gonna shut down the stream. And I wanna be up when it happens. I think it's probably the coolest thing. Just think of the guy, that's his job, right? Just see this Italian dude, he eats, wakes up in the morning, drinks spaghetti. Then in 11 a.m. he switches on the button. Water starts falling. He sits there, hangs for 2 hours, and then in 1 p.m. he just pushes the button again and water shuts down. Pretty awesome job. You know, the good thing about this climb, all the pasta I ate and all the pasta I will eat during the upcoming days, I guess this compensates on like at least half a bowl of pasta. Okay, someone told me I have 5 minutes and I'm there. That's good. There's hope for humanity. C'è tanto da salire?
No?
No, no.
No?
No. Oh. People are giving me strength. You're almost there, they tell me. I think this is it for me. This might be my last video. Guys, there we go. Never doing this again, but I made it. And now we wait for them to shut down the stream. There's a beautiful lookout. I'm gonna head back down, and if by the time I'm down it's off, I'll show you, and if not, then you get to see a nice view. Now, as I'm climbing down the stairs, you know, I think I earned today's lunch. As I'm looking for restaurants, I was thinking I'd share with you guys some tips. In Italy, you have several options for restaurants, okay? So you have I ristoranti, which are literally restaurants, but they're often expensive. And so if you're in Google Maps and you just look for restaurants, you'll find many ristoranti, and then you'll pay a lot more. What you want to do is look for trattorie. Trattoria, it's like an eating place. It is a restaurant in reality, but it's cheaper. Yeah, just instead of looking for restaurants on Google, look for trattoria. And you'll eat very well, and you won't need to break the bank. Another restaurant pro tip is that, you know, there are several sacred things in Italy. One of them, of course, is food, but the other one is the afternoon nap, or the siesta, as it is called in Spain. So restaurants close in like 2:30 p.m. So if you don't come and eat in time, you're in a problem, my friend. So I have like an hour to find a restaurant and eat. Otherwise, it's a gas station lunch for me. So I found this nice trattoria, just 16-minute drive from here. It's called Trattoria Margherita. It looks promising. And the amazing thing is, they shut down at 3:30 in the afternoon. 3:30 in the afternoon. So, you know, it's unheard of. È vostra?
Sì.
Tutto quello?
Tutto.
Sì, ma sono andati sopra, perciò.
Ah, siete un gruppo?
Sì.
Sono saliti sopra e sono andati.
Ma perché voi no, invece?
Perché siamo
anziani, non ce la
Ma no, non è vero.
Come non è vero?
Lei ci fa male, pure la caviglia.
Di dove venite?
Da Napoli.
Ah, che bello. Vabbè, divertitevi.
Ciao, ciao, grazie.
Ciao.
Buon divertimento.
Grazie, anche a voi. So this is what it looks like, you guys, when the water is shut down. Still pretty beautiful, but just the force isn't as strong with this one right now. But now it's 1:30 p.m. and in Italy, 1:30 p.m. means just one thing, pranzo. We need to eat lunch, pranzare. And so this is what we're gonna do right now. Amazing place. See you in the restaurant.